Welcome back, my people, and welcome to Izrock's Movie Reviews, where we're going to dive into Spider-Man 2 from 2004, the sequel, best movie, the best comic book movie of all time, in my opinion, and we're going to get right into it. This is episode 35, and once again, this is Spider-Man week. We have a few days leading up to Spider-Man No Way Home, and for all of those who are going to be a little confused as to what's going to happen in that movie, these are the movies to watch beforehand. So, let's get it. This is the second film in the Sam Raimi trilogy, which finds Peter Parker struggling with his superhuman powers. And because of this, he starts to realize that in order to be a hero, he's going to have to turn back on those that he loves. Mainly, this goes for Mary Jane, his love interest. And this film allows him to be human. In this film, we find him struggling to live on his own, struggling to pay rent, struggling in relationships. His relationship with Aunt May, which I didn't really discuss in the first review for the first movie, is amazing. It's interesting, the dynamic there. And here we see a new villain. This villain has a lot to lose. This villain has many layers to him. The new villain here is Doc Ock, played by Alfred Molina. And Alfred Molina goes all in this character as he wants to kill Spider-Man. Spider-Man 2 is a great follow-up to what was a pretty good movie in part one. I really enjoyed this film. For me, it was better than the original film. Despite its unevenness in the script and its length, the sequel is almost as good as it's gonna get. For me, the sequel stands out because it has a stronger storyline, you know? You see Peter Parker do more than he did in part one. You see him go through his struggles and his progressions. And this movie starts off slow, but despite the slow start, the script is generally very positive. It goes in an upward direction. The spotlight, the flaws in this movie, it's pretty darn gnarly, man. The action is top notch. Visually and technically, it had awesome effects. Jaw-dropping stunts. In this movie, we get the famous train scene. The final action sequence between Spider-Man and Dr. Octopus. The cinematography. Everything was brilliantly staged in this movie. I feel like Dr. Octopus is made into a rather complex villain in this. After the death of his wife, he becomes a villain after being part of his own invention, which is these tentacles that eventually he has installed inside of him. And, you know, you see his progressions throughout the movie and what these tentacles end up doing to him. You know, they end up, you know, having a mind of their own. The remainder of the performances were good. You know, this is a very dramatic and fun film at the same time. That's what makes this movie stand out compared to the other movies in the trilogy. While not admittedly the most charismatic actors I've ever seen in films, but they do their roles justice. Tobey Maguire and Kirsten Dunst, they still give a believable performance. You can tell that the two have amazing chemistry, and all in all, this was an amazing sequel due to that. You know, we see Spider-Man appearing to fly through the streets of New York. And what I like about this movie is he deals with the aspect of, do I want to be Spider-Man or do I just want to be a regular dude, you know, that works, who finds love? And in this one, as the previous movie finished, you see James Franco character, which is Harry. He's hell-bent on finding who killed his father, and he knows Spider-Man did it. And in this movie, he comes really close to finding out who Spider-Man is, up till the end, where, I don't want to spoil it for you, but eventually he sees and finds out who, and when he does, forget about it. He becomes distraught, and the story starts to take shape in a different way there, leading up to the next film, which I'm gonna do a review right after this one. And it's been debated which film was the best one, the first one or this one. And this one, hands down to me, was the more likable film. Although the original gives you everything you want in the aspect of a story, right? Great beginning, great middle, great ending. This one, the beginning is a little slow because they try to engage you and they try to tell a story of what's going on with Peter in a very slow way. And after you see the movie, you realize you appreciate it a little more. Okay, the character's a little more fleshed out and he has more layers to him, more story to him. So, you know, it was necessary for them to start out that way. But once the action gets going, once you see the plot and the plot twist coming, you're like, okay, the first 10, 15 minutes were worth it. You know, they try to explain everything that's going to happen and what's going to happen, because there's going to be so much things thrown at you at one point that they don't want to overwhelm you with a lot of, you know, so they ease their way into you as a moviegoer. And this movie was splendid. You know, if you're going to do a sequel to a film that made almost $1 billion in the box office, this is definitely the way to go. This was definitely a 4.5 out of 5. I think it was right there with the original, but I give it slightly more praise. And definitely go check this one out. All right, if you like the video, please hit that like button, hit that notification bell, and please subscribe to the next one. Peace.